don't know if this story is true, but I heard that a funk band Tower of Power said that we are playing the same notes as everyone else, but we are playing them shorter. So that was the reason they gave for their success, and there is something to that with music. Another cliché is to say that the pauses in the music is more important than the notes themselves, and probably no smoke without a fire for that cliché. I need to make some space here for the Funkalyzer to fit in the design, and this beautiful bridge made by Tim Keller from ADHD Engineering is something special. I promised him to not take the angle grinder to this thing. He actually literally asked me, please don't angle grind my beautiful part. So I kept my promise, I took the chop saw instead. I haven't told Tim about this yet, so he will discover right now. Hello, Tim. I'm very, very sorry, but I actually was very serious. I made a practice cut and I squared the cut up on the CNC machine, so I think the final finish is actually not super far away from what you sent me. There you go. For this build, I wanted to make an extra effort on my finish and the look of the part. I didn't want to mess up Tim's beautiful bridge, and I really didn't want to mess up Carlos Montoro's work from AnjudaGuitars.com, who has been building this custom cyber bass. So I wanted to design something in the design tradition of the cyber bass, and I wanted this mild steel part that I'm welding together here to have a little bit of a more mature finish. I'm still kind of new to working with metals, and I never really learned how to make finishes, but on this project, this part was so small, so I wanted to give it a little bit extra. So you can see I cut out these templates here, and then I spray glued them on, and then it's easy to drill the hole where it should be. I can cut outside the line and then sand down to the line. On electric guitars and basses, there is a grounding wire going from the electronics up to the bottom of the bridge, and I needed to drill a hole for that grounding wire, but my drills were too short for this steep angle, so I made a long drill from like a stainless 3mm rod. I just sharpened it and it went through the wood. But now I can start to think about the finish of this piece, and I'm cleaning it with acetone, and then I'm using this permablue blackening. I think I saw something of that from Jimmy D'Aresta the first time I saw it. It's really cool. It has some kind of chemical reaction with the metal, and it protects it a little bit from rust, and it makes it kind of black. I really love this look. But when I tried it on the bass, I thought that the black was really not the same black as the black of the plastic buttons and the plastic mics. I took away the black from the surface, but I left it on the edges, and that look I think was really good. I tried to seal the surface with some lacquer. Now I can screw on the felt. That was actually Marius who taught me that you can actually screw with wood screws straight into this felt. And I'm using these washers to create a kind of an arc, because the strings on the bass is not like on a one plane. They're like situated in an arc, and the strings goes between the screws. To finish the design off, I wanted to have some cool looking knobs. I designed a couple of knobs in Fusion, and I cut it from aluminium on the CNC. I think the CNC machine is actually doing pretty well with metals. Maybe not if you measure the tolerances, but for things like this, it's perfect. And I'm using a hex bolt because I don't have a lathe. Otherwise, I would love to make some kind of manual machined threaded screw for this application. But this is a good workaround with all the tools and all the material that I have at home. Listen to this ratchet sound. I was not really happy actually how this looked, and I wanted to make the same contrast as the theme on the cyber base, like black with metal. So I spray painted the bolt and it just looked messy. I was afraid that the blackening wouldn't be black enough and that it wouldn't look like the plastic parts on the cyber base, but in the end the spray paint looked awful, so I went back to the blackening, and as you can see, I'm very happy about this finish.